YouTube, it's me, Jay Brittany. I just wanted to make an update video of frequently asked questions and just an update about me. First things first, thank you so much for everybody who subscribed. I now have like 4,000 and blah subscribers, no longer just 1,000. And I'm just so happy that people like my videos and they just want to subscribe and be my friend now. If you're not subscribed yet, I suggest it. Because you can get videos in the future and all that stuff. And just to let you know now, I will never be those people who go like, vote 5 stars for my video, 5 stars for blah. I won't do that ever because I just don't care for getting paid on this thing. I just do it for fun. Even though I've been asked to be partner, like, I just really don't care. Okay, I want to get to the questions part though. I wrote down all the frequently asked questions and the stuff I need to talk about. A lot of people ask me, do I actually play the games that I play the music to on YouTube? Of course I do. My brother and I like find a way of bonding by playing video games. My brother, who's a little bit older than me, found a way for us to get along, which is to play video games. So ever since I was like 5 years old, I've been playing Final Fantasy and Nintendo kind of games, Mario Kart, all kinds of games. I played a lot of games, but I kind of got more into RPG games because like I like storylines and not just straight up, shoot you and you're dead, you know. I like RPG opposed to first-person shooter. Though I did like Grand Theft Auto, even though it's a bad game, but I like that game. A lot of people also ask me, do I have sheet music? No, I don't have any sheet music because I started violin when I was 3 years old. So 3-year-olds really don't read notation. Kind of hard for us to read at three. So my teacher had me learn music by learning it by ear first, and then she would bring the music later. So learning to play by ear at such an early age like made it a lot easier for me to like just play melodies. Like Final Fantasy music, the melodies are very, very easy for me to like pick up because most of them are not really complicated. Well, some of them are complicated, but I've trained my ear well enough that I can just listen to something and I can just play it back. Opposed to going on Google and trying to look for notation, it's a lot easier for me to just play it by ear, so that's why I don't have sheet music. Sorry to those who are wanting sheet music and looking for it. I wish I could tell you how to find it, but only thing I can think of is just like Google or something. I'm not sure. But another question, how long have I been playing? I've been playing for 17 years, started at 3. 17 years later, I am 20 years old, obviously, and I'm in college, so people also ask, do I have a private lesson teacher? Yes, I do. I've had private lessons all my life, pretty much. I highly recommend getting a private lesson teacher for violin, or at least getting a private lesson teacher for the basics. If you don't get a lesson teacher for the basics, that can set you back at least 2 years, because if you learn the littlest thing wrong, it really, really hurts you. Like, if you were to go to a private lesson teacher, like, later on after you've been playing the violin, you'll be finding yourself going back in the rewind, which makes people more frustrated and makes people tend to quit the violin because the teacher has to now go back and, like, show you how to properly hold the violin, and which can make things frustrating because you already know how to play, kind of play, you know, like your version of playing, but really the right way has to be played because learning it the right way really makes things easier. Because if you learn it the wrong way, that makes you suffer from tone, meaning the noise that comes out of your violin, rhythm, like learning how to read notation properly, and then also learning how to play stuff slow and fast or playing things with emotion. Like there's different variations on playing, like vibrato, there's like certain speeds to make things certain sound a certain way. Like if you're not taught that, those little things, it really does hurt. And I see comments all the time with people going like, I'm gonna learn without a teacher, or like it is possible to learn without a teacher. Yes, I'm not gonna say it's impossible, but I find that it makes things more possible when you do have that guidance and whenever you properly learn how to hold a violin right. I know I'm like really stressing this, but it is a big stress. Like you really, really, really have to have a teacher. If I didn't have a teacher, I would sound like pure crap. To be honest. Another question, do I play in an orchestra? Yes, I do. I play in my college orchestra. It's required, and I've been playing in orchestra since I was like 7 years old, and I was that bad 7 year old in the back of the orchestra that made noises like on my violin during tuning. Like I would play the car alarm. Like I can play like a car alarm on my violin. Like I swear it sounds like exact car alarm. I would play that in the back of the orchestra while people were tuning to distract and just be bad. But obviously I don't do that now because I'm older. And I play in like a good orchestra, and I sit like third chair in the first violin section, so I can't be like fooling around and the seniors and juniors looking at me like I'm crazy, you know? So yeah. Also, people have put in the comments a lot about the sound issues in my earlier videos. I found out from my brother that that the reason why my sound sounds so bad is because my sub, meaning that I have a bass subwoofer for my computer. I have that for my computer, and like it's basically 100 watts. So in my earlier on videos, I had 100 watts sub going on in the background while I was recording, and my camera suffered the trauma, which of course the mic suffered the trauma, which is like my camera like bouncing around, I guess, or I don't know exactly what happens, but that explains the noise in the background. Now if you look at my videos based off of my last update video, you do not hear any noise because I basically turn my sub totally off whenever I'm recording now, because it really improves the sound. Even though I don't have like one of those HD high definition cameras yet, like it really does make the sound a lot better, and you don't hear that noise in the background anymore, which was annoying people. And then also another thing that kind of annoys people is the face tracking thing. I have to have the face tracking because I tend to move around a lot whenever I'm playing my violin, and I want to make sure I'm still in the frame, so I have my camera purposely be on face tracking to make sure that I'm still in the frame no matter what I do, because you know, notice I move from side to side whenever I play. That's out of habit. So it's really, the face tracking is for you and for me too, because I can't stand it if I'm out the frame, because some of my videos my hand is not, like my whole body is not in the frame, and I like for people to see what I'm doing, like for people who play by ear, they want to see what I'm doing with my fingers, you know. So yeah. Request. I see all your requests and I will do them in the future. I just have a couple of guidelines, like personal guidelines that I do. I only do requests of songs that are not redundant. I don't do songs that plays the same thing over and over and over again, like every 10 seconds is the same thing, pretty much. I play songs that are at least a minute long and have interesting melody lines and just like stuff that sounds interesting, stuff that would be interesting to other people, because you know, like YouTube is for everybody to watch, and I want to play stuff that everybody would like, you know, like a kind of a neutral thing, and then also stuff that I like as well. But yeah, I do see your requests in the comments and in the profile section. And then also, please don't message me unless you want to collab. Do not message me, because I do not look at my messages. Like seriously, your message will get lost, because I don't look at my messages. I just look at mainly my comments, because like I get my comments mobile. I look at my comments, and then I look at my profile, and then that's it. So if you have a request, leave it in the comments or leave it in the profile. Like leave it over there or somewhere. I don't know exactly where to point, but like just leave it down in the comments. Do that. And once again, thank you so much for like subscribing and just being my friend out here on YouTube and watching me play stuff that I like to play. I will start coming out with more videos maybe next week or maybe the week after. Not sure, but I will be having new videos coming out. So thank you, and I guess I'll see you guys later. Bye-bye.